Hi children, hope you all very healthy and safety. Today we are going to learn the lesson tables and chairs. If you know the tables thoroughly, it's the very easiest for you. Whenever you will find free time, use that for learn tables. In this lesson, today our concept is a multiplication. A multiplication is nothing but arrangement of things in an array. I repeat, multiplication is nothing but arrangement of things in an array. For example, arrangement of chairs in the classroom, arrangement of children in the school assembly. Example number one, if Amy had three cats and each one had four legs, how could we find how many legs all the cats had? Shall we find it, children? Yes. The cat number 1 is equal to 4 legs. The cat number 2 is equal to 4 legs. The cat number 3 is equal to 4 legs. If we add it all together, the answer is 12 legs. Here, I need to remember one thing, children. A multiplication is also known as a repeated addition. I repeat, the multiplication is also known as a repeated addition. So multiplication is very fast way to add the equal numbers. A repeated addition we couldn't use for all the examples. So a multiplication is fast way to add equal numbers. Since all three cats have four legs, instead of adding them together, we could multiply. So each cat have four legs. And the number of cats we had? Three cats. So if we multiply, 4 threes are 12. 4 threes are 12 legs. Example number 2. How many legs altogether would two boys have? How many legs altogether would two boys have? Can you think of a multiplication problem that shows this? Shall we do it, children? Yes. And the number of legs each one having is 2 legs. And the number of boys we had? 2 boys. Here we should use 2 table. So 2 twos are 4. 4 legs. Example number 3. If a crayon box holds 7 crayons, how many crayons would 2 boxes hold? Can you think of a multiplication problem that shows this? Shall we do it, children? Yes. The number of crayons we have each is 7. 7 crayons. And the number of boxes we had is 2. Here we should use the table 2. 7 twos are 14 crayons. Example number 4. If every teacher has 3 books and there are 5 teachers, how many books do they all have? If every teacher has 3 books and there are 5 teachers, how many books do they all have? 5 teachers and each one having 3 books. And number of teachers we have is 5. And number of books we had is 3. And 5 threes are 15 books. Example number 6. If every desk has 1 apple and there are 9 desks, how many apples are there in all? If every desk has 1 apple and there are 9 desks, how many apples are there in all? Yes, it's a set of apples. Every desk has 1 apple and there are 9 desks. Shall we do it, children? Yes. The apple we had is 1 and the desk we had is 9. We should use the 9 table here. 1 nines are 9. So we are having 9 apples. Multiplication involves sets of objects. Can you write a multiplication problem for these sets, children? Shall we? Yes. Here they have given a sets of fishes. 5 sets of 2 each. So a 5 into 2, 10. Here they have given 3 sets of 4 each. 3 fours are 12.
here they have given 3 sets of 3 each. 3 threes are 9. Here they have given 4 sets of 2 each. 4 twos are 8. Here they have given some examples. Before solving, I draw a set to represent each of the following. Then solve the problems. Shall we, children? Yes. The first one, the 2 nines are 18. The next one is a 5 ones are 5. Here I need to remember one thing. If we multiply the number with 1, the answer is the same number. The next one, 5 5s are? Yes, correct, 25. The next one is 4 into 0. 4 zeros are 0. Here also I need to remember one thing, children. If we multiply the number with 0, the answer is 0. The next one, 8 ones are 8. The last one, 6 fours are 24. Thank you, children. Thank you for your time.